Welcome to the clinical skills video for peripheral venous cannulation. Prior to performing any procedure on a patient, you must ensure that you have got the correct patient and that the patient is fully aware and informed of the procedure you're about to perform. You must ensure that you then wash your hands thoroughly using the 11-stage approach. You must now assemble your equipment. Prior to opening the packs and assembling your equipment, you must clean the procedure tray with the appropriate wipe and allow it to dry thoroughly. The equipment required for this procedure is the appropriate size venous cannula, tourniquet, non-sterile gloves, skin preparation wipes, an octopus or extension set, and a syringe with saline. In this example, we are using the Nottingham University Hospital's cannulation packs. These contain a non-ported cannula, but ported cannulas may be used. Within the pack, you will find a tourniquet, appropriate size cannula, skin preparation wipe, a label for putting in the patient's notes, and a dressing. In this example as well, we're not using pre-prepared 10ml syringes with saline already in situ, so we'll require a drawing up needle, a 10ml vial of 0.9% normal saline, and a 10ml syringe. When preparing all the equipment and drawing up the saline, must ensure an aseptic non-touch technique is maintained at all times. Must also ensure that the octopus, bung or extension set that is being used is pre-primed prior to the procedure. This is to ensure that no air is left in situ and the patient receives no air emboli. And you also require gauze, which doesn't come within the cannulation pack. If a cannulation pack is not available within your clinical area, the other disposable items can be obtained. Once the equipment is all prepared, you must gel your hands before applying an apron and non-sterile gloves. On the label, you must write the date and time the cannula has been inserted. Position and expose the arm and identify a suitable vein. Ideally, this should be a large forearm vein. Apply the tourniquet, and once the tourniquet has been applied, recheck the vein. Ensure your patient is ready to proceed and then clean the chosen site for 30 seconds and allow it to dry for 30 seconds.
Remove the cannula from its pack using a no-touch technique. Stretch the skin, then insert the needle with the bevel upwards in line with the vein at an angle of approximately 30 degrees. Advance the needle, observing for the first flashback in the hub of the cannula. Partially withdraw the stylet and observe for the second flashback along the cannula length. Level off the cannula and then slowly advance the needle into the vein. Once the needle is fully in, the technique will vary depending on whether you are using a ported or non-ported cannula. The non-ported cannulas will give flashback but won't bleed from the hub of the cannula once the needle is removed. Here we demonstrate what to do if you are using a ported cannula.
Place the gauze underneath the cannula, release the tourniquet, apply pressure to the vein above where the cannula is in, and remove the needle and dispose of it appropriately within a sharps bin.
If using a non-ported cannula, you will not need to place the gauze underneath the cannula and apply pressure to the vein due to the fact that the cannula won't bleed.
Attach the appropriate connection device or extension set if you're not taking blood samples at this point. Flush the cannula whilst holding and securing the cannula in place with your other hand. Remembering to clamp off the extension set, remove the syringe, remove the gauze, and then apply the dressing to secure the cannula in place. Most dressings have two single strips that you place either side of the cannula. Remove the middle square of the dressing and then the back. This just makes it a bit easier. Finally, remove the last outer piece of dressing. Ensure the sticker with the date and time is stuck down to the patient. secure the cannula appropriately, ensure that you complete the appropriate documentation to go into the patient's notes, and ensure that the patient is okay and explain any complications that they may encounter.
In summary, ensure that you have prepared the patient and confirmed their identity. Assemble and prepare all equipment, ensuring an aseptic non-touch technique. Identify the appropriate vein. Insert the needle at approximately 30 degrees. Withdraw the needle slightly to observe for any flashback and then advance your cannula. Once cannula is fully in, prior to removing the needle, ensure that you have put in place gauze, remove the tourniquet and apply pressure to the vein. The needle can then be safely removed. Dispose of all sharps safely. Attach an extension set. Flush the cannula. Ensure the cannula is secured. Provide any aftercare advice to the patient and ensure that the correct documentation is filled out.